biggest challenge of Tibet is attitude. Even big people educated and big men and women, you hear someone saying, ah, umwana yabudde, meaning that if the child has failed, take the child to Tibet. And you see, that is an attitude. Now, that attitude, the decentralized admission is also removing it.
Addressing private institutions, Loy Muhwezi, the Commissioner for Technical Vocational Education and Training, urged them to prioritize legal establishment and to offer courses aligned with national needs. She also announced plans for comprehensive institution supervision at the onset of each semester, underscoring the commitment to maintain quality standards in line with national benchmarks.
Now we need standards if we are to go into the draw income and also industrializing the country. So we are saying people now must come out and tell us, for you are training in what and at which level. We guide you, we support you, we look at the instructors and teachers you are using. We work with you to grow.
Despite the numerous loads in technical and vocational institutions, Muhwezi lamented over the limited government sponsorship, attributing it to partly the lingering effects of the COVID-19 pandemic.
Most of the institutions, for only year one, you find they have like 200 slots minimum. But the government sponsorship is the one that is limited, because you also know we are still recovering from COVID. So the government sponsorship is the one which is limited.
Highlighting the ministry's commitment to inclusivity, Muhwezi disclosed that the previous year saw scholarships awarded to 19 special needs students and over 60 girls. She expressed hope for continued support in this year, pending adequate funding from government and non-government sources. Story by Sharon Navasirie for the news.